Okay, hi everyone. I'll be conducting today's session, which is on Apache, PHP and MySQL installation, which you will require for Moodle installation, which will be coming soon. Now, first on your terminal, just type apt-get install Apache 2. This is the command to install the Apache server on your system. Oh yes, before that, I just forgot, you need to have root permissions for running this command. So you just do su, enter, and enter your root password. Okay, so type sudo su. It will ask for your account password. You should see root at your laptop name, like this. The command is sudo su. Is everyone done? Okay. Then just run this command apt-get install Apache 2. Which is apt-get. This will install Apache 2. Now the Apache 2 is installed on the system. Now since it is a server, it will have configuration files which are placed at /etc/apache2 folder. So we'll just do an ls of it /etc. Is it done with everyone? Yeah, so now ls space /etc/apache2 should give you all the configuration files. All the configuration files are stored in the, under this directory. Okay, and since it is a web server, you will have a web root wherein all your web files will be stored. Okay, so that is the web root is at /var/www. These are the important directories you should remember. Okay, for now it has a dummy file called index.html. You can do a cat of it. A simple file which says it works. Okay. Now just try restarting the server. The command for which is /etc/init.d/apache2 restart. Now this is giving me some errors. Let's see, yeah, a server name not found. Let's see how to fix it. So now to fix that error, just add the line, add the following line at the end of apache2.conf /etc/apache2/apache2.conf. Says at the, go to the last line and say server name space your machine host name. Let me show you. Say this is the file /etc/apache2/apache2.conf. vim is a text editor. I hope everyone knows about VIM. Go to the last line, say insert, say server name space your machine name. Now my machine name is IITB dash laptop, sorry, so it is IITB dash laptop. No, it has to be exactly as it appears on your command prompt. This server name space your host name. No, right now your machine is the server. This is my host name, it might be different in your case. Is everyone done? Okay. I save this file, come out. Now try restarting the server. Now see, I am not getting that error. Okay, now let's just test whatever we have done. We have actually done just two steps, which is installation of Apache 2 and adding that line in apache2.conf. That's it. Okay, just go to your browser and type this line, this URL 127.0.0.1, and it should show you that page, that HTML page that we saw 2 minutes back. .0.1 is the IP address which points to your machine by default. So it says it works. Okay. And if you remember it, this file was in /var/www, which is your root, web root. Now if you don't have a proxy set, this will work. IITB dash laptop. Yeah, this is your Mozilla Firefox, edit, preferences. So go to network tab, okay, yeah, and settings, and you must be having a manual proxy configuration here, which is required because if you want to access outside websites. So now let us begin with PHP installation. For installing PHP, just type this command apt-get install php5 lib apache 2 dash mod dash php5. Apt-get install php5 lib apache 2 mod php5. Okay, now restart your Apache 2. So now Apache 2 has restarted. So PHP 5 is done now. That's just one command. Okay. Yeah. Just install PHP 5. And that lib apache 2 is actually a module which is for Apache, for so that you can run php5 in Apache. That's why you need to restart the server again. okay, and that's it, your PHP installation is done. Then we move over to MySQL installation. For that you need the command apt-get install mysql-server space php5-mysql. Yeah, it will ask for a root password, give some password which is which you will remember, you will require it for Moodle installation. You will get a blue screen. Okay, it seems MySQL server is already installed on the system, so it says it is already the newest version. Okay, but in your case, if it does not have, it will install and it will give you a blue screen which asks you for a root password which you should remember, because you will require it for Moodle installation. Okay, yeah, when you run this command apt-get install MySQL server php5-mysql, it will in the process it will give you a blue screen which will ask you for a root password, and it will ask you twice, once for reconfirming. So give the same password in both the cases and remember the password. You will require it for MySQL installation, Moodle installation. Okay, it's a good idea to note down your MySQL password so that you know you can refer to it later, because it is a root password, remember. Okay, now let's see how to run the MySQL client. For that, type the command mysql space dash u root dash p mysql. Minus u is for this user, root, login as root, minus p prompt for password. And MySQL is a default database which is already created. Now enter the root password, and when it asks you for a password, type the same password that you entered in that blue screen. You just don't forget your root password, okay? It creates a lot of problems. So we were at this line, MySQL minus u root minus p. You will get a prompt like this. Okay, the MySQL prompt. Now you are inside MySQL. Then just type this query, select star from user. Okay, now you are getting a huge, it is actually a table which has the list of all the users, the present database users. Okay, then just type quit and you're out on the prompt. Then how to add a user account? Type this command mysql minus u root minus p. It will ask you for the root password. Is for ask prompt for password. Yeah, no, it won't allow you to enter because root has a password. Now you are not selecting a default database. Then type this command, create user, new user at localhost, exactly as this is. So it says, localhost is your machine and new user is the new user that we are adding. Okay. It says query okay. Then you grant all the privileges to the user, for which you type grant all privileges. On star dot star means all tables of all databases. Two, new user at localhost. It says query okay. Now your user is created. Now let's see whether you can log in through the new user account. So type quit. And then type this command, MySQL minus u new user minus p MySQL. MySQL minus u new user minus p MySQL. When you are asked for a password, just enter, because you don't have, you have not set a password yet. So it is using the MySQL database. Now if you type this query, select star from user, you should get this new user that you have added in the database. Select star from user. You see this new user is added. Okay, so type quit and you're out. That's it.